From being dropped in the jungle to having a 95% fail rate, here are six of the most powerful Special Forces units in the world. Number 6. Seyeret Matkal, Israel. Known as simply the unit, the Seyeret Matkal is a special forces unit of the Israel Defense Forces. First formed in 1957, this Israeli special forces unit focuses on gathering intelligence, reconnaissance, anti-terrorism, and hostage rescue outside of Israel. Candidates are selected for their high physical and intellectual capabilities. The unit is modeled after the British Army's Special Air Service with the motto, "Who dares, wins." This unit is the Israeli equivalent of the US Delta Force or the UK's Special Air Service. Volunteers and hand-picked soldiers undergo a grueling selection camp for potential recruits. Once they are chosen, they train for 18 months and are considered by many sources to be the most effective counter-terrorism force in the world. After training in hand-to-hand combat, urban warfare, and night fighting, at some point the recruit will get kidnapped by veterans who will take him somewhere in the desert to be tortured and interrogated to see who will break. There are solo hikes where if you get lost or break a leg, there is no one there to help you. Several people have died during training. It is highly secretive and has taken on mythic status with its quick victories in Egypt, Lebanon, Jordan, Uganda, and all over the world. During the Olympic Games in 1972, when Israeli athletes were killed in Munich, the mission to hunt down the members of Black September was turned over to the unit. Operation Thunderbolt, or Entebbe, demonstrated the reach of Seyeret Matkal and its strength to the world. On June 27, 1976, an Air France plane departed from Ben Gurion International Airport in Lod, Israel. During a layover in Athens, hijackers boarded the plane with large bags containing guns and grenades. They forced the pilot to divert the plane to Entebbe Airport in Uganda. The Seyeret Matkal attacked the airport in a daring raid and freed 103 Jewish hostages. More recently, in 2003, four Palestinians kidnapped an Israeli taxi driver after he gave them a ride in his cab. Seyeret Matkal located the driver and rescued him from a 10-meter-deep pit in an abandoned factory in a suburb of Ramallah. Number 5. GSG-9, Germany. GSG-9 is the German abbreviation of Grenzschutzgruppe 9, or Border Guard Group 9, which is easier to say. It is the elite counterterrorism and special operations unit of the German Federal Police, and it was created from a tragedy. In 1972, the Palestinian terrorist movement Black September kidnapped 11 Israeli athletes during the Summer Olympic Games in Munich, West Germany. Two of the athletes were killed in the Olympic Village during the initial assault on the athletes' rooms. The German police, untrained and unequipped for counterterrorism, attempted to rescue the athletes. The operation failed. One policeman, five of the eight kidnappers, and the remaining nine hostages died. The event came to be known as the Munich Massacre. As a result, 6 months after Munich, German officials created the Bundesgrenzschutz, which means Federal Border Guard Service. In 2005, they were renamed Bundespolizei, or Federal Police. GSG-9 is an elite unit drawn from the Federal Police. Interestingly, candidates came from a regular police force rather than military because German law forbids the use of the military against civilians. Today, GSG-9 is deployed in cases of hostage-taking, kidnapping, terrorism, and extortion. The group can also secure locations, neutralize targets, track down fugitives, and sometimes conduct sniper operations. Furthermore, the group is very active in developing and testing methods and tactics for these missions. Experts estimate that since their inception in 1973, the GSG-9 have completed more than 1,500 missions and have only fired their weapons 5 times. Number 4. Alpha Group, Russia. Alpha Group, also known as Spetsgruppe A, is a special unit within the Center for Special Operations of the Russian FSB. For those who don't know, the FSB is the successor of the Soviet KGB. Founded in 1974 in response to the Munich massacre as well, Alphas are the most famous special force in Russia. They guard the Russian state and ensure its security and are the most powerful unit in the country. The general public, aka pretty much all of us, know very little about their work, and once they leave the service, they are reluctant to give interviews or talk about their work in the special forces, probably with good reason. They arrest terrorists, liquidate terrorist groups, solve complex hostage situations, and protect important people, objects, and events. When the Winter Olympics came to Sochi, they were deployed as part of the event's security. Candidates for Alpha Group are between 22 and 27 years old, must have a university education, must be mentally and physically healthy, and possess high moral qualities. Testing candidates takes more than a year. If they pass, they go through 3 years of training. They must excel at infantry training, parachuting, diving, sniper operations, practical shooting, martial arts, and even foreign languages. Once done with training, operatives are organized into groups of 12, which are divided into teams of four. Their basic operation motto adds an extra layer of severity to all of that training. Where Alpha appears, compromise stops. Alpha Group first gained notoriety in 1979 for leading the assault on the presidential palace in Kabul during the initial phases of Russia's invasion of Afghanistan. According to a former Alpha Group member, the commanding officer of Alpha Group ordered for them to kill everyone in the building. In 1985, Hezbollah captured four Russian diplomats. Various nations, including the U.S., tried to negotiate with Hezbollah, but no progress was made. After one diplomat was killed, Russia sent in Alpha Group. To everyone's surprise, the terrorists released the hostages not long after. Some experts believe the release came because of Russia's long-standing policy to target not the terrorists, but their families. One rumor has it that Alpha Group kidnapped a relative of one of the terrorists, then castrated, killed, and dismembered him. They sent the parts to the hostage takers with a letter explaining the same would be done to all of their families. Number 3. The National Gendarmerie Intervention Group, France. This is another elite special operations force that was created in response to the 1972 Munich massacre. The GIGN, or the National Gendarmerie Intervention Group, was the French answer to the lack of counterterrorism special forces units across Europe. The GIGN specializes in terrorist attacks and hijackings of planes and ships. In 2007, they were reorganized to provide a 200-man, highly trained team to respond to hostage situations. They are the only commando force to carry a .357 Magnum revolver as their sidearm. U.S. Navy SEALs, Rangers, and SWAT teams regularly cross-train with the GIGN. In fact, the GIGN probably has the toughest training program in the world, with a washout rate of 95%. On the first day of training, candidates must bungee jump from a bridge and swim through a tunnel with hands and feet bound. If you make it through your first day, then training takes 10 months. Training covers hostage negotiation, ship assault, high-altitude, low-opening parachute drops, sniper marksmanship, desert ops, combat skiing, desert operations, rappelling, and hand-to-hand combat. They also receive more gun training than any other special forces group in the world. After that, life is fairly busy. The GIGN are called upon for at least 60 operations a year. In 1994, when four terrorists from the Algerian Armed Islamic Group hijacked an Air France flight, GIGN responded. The terrorists killed three passengers before the plane was flown to Marseille, where the GIGN stormed it and killed the four hijackers. Plot leaders said later that the plan was to detonate the aircraft over the Eiffel Tower. The first man through the door shot three of the hijackers but spent months in the hospital after being badly injured. He lost the use of one arm but returned to the GIGN as a shooting instructor. However, that doesn't beat an operation in 1976, 4 years after the GIGN were formed. Rebels in Djibouti hijacked a school bus transporting 30 French schoolchildren and threatened to kill everyone if France didn't acquiesce to their demands. Instead of negotiating, the GIGN were sent. Four snipers opened fire on the school bus and killed all of the rebels save one. GIGN stormed the bus, killed the one man they missed, and rescued the children. Number 2. Delta Force, USA. Delta Force, officially known as 1st Special Forces Operational Detachment Delta, is one of many U.S. special mission units primarily focused on counterterrorism. SFOD Delta's name has changed several times over the years. Colloquially, it is known as Delta Force, but recently it was renamed the Combat Applications Group and is now officially known as Army Compartmented Elements. Delta Force currently receives its recruits from all over the Army, and there are no civilian to Delta enlistment programs. Though Delta Force is specifically directed to kill or capture high-value units or dismantle terrorist cells, Delta Force remains extremely flexible. It can engage in direct action missions, hostage rescues, and covert missions working directly with the Central Intelligence Agency, as well as high-ranking protective services of senior leaders during visits in war-torn countries. The Joint Special Operations Command, or JSOC, directly controls Delta Force while administratively supported by the Army Special Operations Command, or USASOC. Formed in 1977, its first commander was Colonel Charles Beckwith. After working with British Special Air Services, Beckwith saw a need for a precision strike force to face the growing threat of terrorism around the world. Beckwith took most of his candidates from other Special Forces groups to create the first unit. Most of Delta Force's missions are classified. However, some have been declassified and noted publicly in media reports and books written by Delta operators. The classic movie Black Hawk Down was inspired by a Delta Force mission. In 2015, Kurdish fighters in Iraq discovered that ISIS was preparing to execute dozens of captives. The U.S. sent Delta Force commandos who were able to rescue 70 hostages. Officially, the U.S. does not acknowledge Delta Force or other covert counterterrorism units under its Joint Special Operations Command. Also known as the Unit, Delta, along with SEAL Team 6, are supposed to remain secret and unknown to the public. Number 1. Special Air Service, United Kingdom. In 1941, David Stirling created the Special Air Service as a desert raiding force during World War II. Inserted behind German lines in northern Africa, the SAS carried out sabotage missions and wreaked havoc along supply lines. However, despite their success, the SAS was disbanded in 1946, only to be revived the following year and used during the Korean War. They have been in operation ever since and are considered the original Special Forces unit and have inspired similar units throughout the world. Their insignia bears the phrase, "Who dares wins." The physical requirements are harsh. The selection process lasts 5 months and has a 90% fail rate. Candidates must be able to swim 2 miles in an hour and a half and run 4 miles in 30 minutes. They must also be able to complete a 40-mile march known as endurance with a full pack in 20 hours, which drastically cuts the number of recruits. The survivors of this march will go on to continuation training and will be dropped in the jungle in Brunei. The final test is a 36-hour interrogation session meant to break the candidate's will. Obviously, not everyone makes it through the training, but those who do are transferred to perform training sessions with MI5 and MI6 security and intelligence services, so the candidates can undertake counter-espionage operations. As with most of these elite special forces, several recruits have died during training. One example of SAS's actions is Operation Marlborough in Iraq. In July 2005, a sniper team comprised of British SAS and American Delta Force targeted a house in the heart of Baghdad that contained suicide bombers. They could not storm the building because if one of the bombers detonated, civilians in neighboring buildings would die. All three bombers had to be shot simultaneously to prevent any of them from detonating. The three suicide bombers came out into the street and the sniper team opened fire all at the same time. The three bombers died instantly, never getting the chance to detonate. If you would like to learn more about other special forces from around the world, let me know in the comments below. Make sure to subscribe and I'll see you next time. Bye everyone!